Hey everybody, welcome to my next singing video here on YouTube. Today I got a song here called Yours Love. It's by Waylon Jennings from 1968, before his outlaw period, written by Harlan Howard. This will be the second Harlan Howard written song that I've done in a row by Waylon Jennings. This is my 21st Waylon Jennings song on my YouTube playlist, My Karaoke Songs. Although this one here is not technically karaoke because there isn't a carafun version of this song, so I'm doing it over Waylon's voice. This is the 224th video on my playlist in total on YouTube. This is yet another song that I did on SingSnap about 4 years ago. There's a lot of those, about 172 of those. Yeah. But first off, on this video here, I want to read a little paragraph out of Waylon's autobiography that talks about Yours Love, the song. Here it is, Waylon, the autobiography. By Waylon Jennings and Lenny Kaye. Waylon and autobiography. Just a paragraph here. So this one here, it's talking about Harlan Howard. Waylon says, he wrote every morning, till it was time to hang out. I've never been able to be that kind of productive writer. I've got to have something that really turns me on to the idea, which is why so many of my songs are autobiographical. I'll take things that happen to me and try to understand them, sometimes making them sadder or happier to encompass more of an audience, a writer's prerogative. Harlan was different. He wouldn't write if he was troubled or upset. In his mind, that was frivolous, though he'd remember the feeling and tap into it when he needed the emotion. An exception was Yours Love, which was a hit for me in 1968. He had written a poem to his to-be wife as a wedding, next page, as a wedding present. And then, as he said, writers are such sluts. That's a quote. He put a melody to it and thought of it as his best, most positive love song. Yeah, so that's Harlan Howard, the songwriter. This is another song off of this CD here that I've been working on for quite a while now. I'm skipping quite a few songs here now to get to this one today, track 11. There's a bunch of songs on here like Come On Home, Kicking Our Hearts Around, Right Won't Touch a Hand, Don't Let the Sun Set on You, Tulsa, that I already did on videos before, so I'll skip those over and do Yours Love today. So Yours Love, let's see here. Well, first off, we'll talk about the songwriter Harlan Howard. He was born on September the 8th, 1927, as Harlan Perry Howard in Detroit, Michigan. He was also a performer. He was inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame in 1997. He was at one time married to country singer Jan Howard, one of the so-called grand ladies of the Grand Ole Opry. His fourth wife was a songwriter named Sharon Rucker. They divorced in 1988. 148 songs that were recorded by more than one artist were written or co-written by Howard, from You Took Her Off My Hands by Wynn Stewart on January 30th, 1956, to Melancholy Blue by Rebecca Lynn Howard, no relation, on May 2nd, 2000. Nine of those songs were originally recorded or released by Jennings, including Yours Love. Howard died on March 3rd, 2002, aged 74. Yeah, well, a little bit about how I first heard the song. It was on the Stingray Country Classics TV channel. There, I heard it years ago on that channel. I always enjoyed it. Yours Love is a real love song. Tells the story of what the singer hopes will be a lifelong love for his wife-to-be, in which he shares all the pleasures and joys, the material things, as well as the non-material things, with her, until his death is the only thing that breaks them apart in the end. Waylon Jennings made the original recording of Yours Love on April the 16th, 1968. The session was produced by Chet Atkins. The song was released as a single on October 12th, 1968, on the RCA Victor label, with the B-side Six Strings Away. The single entered the U.S. Billboard Hot Country Songs Top 40 on November the 23rd, 1968, Jennings' 11th Top 40 country hit of his career. The single charted for 16 weeks, peaking at number 5. It also reached number 5 on the Canadian RPM Country Tracks chart. The song was included as track 7 on Jennings' December 1968 RCA Victor album, Jewels. 17 cover versions of Yours Love have been released. 16 of those were with English lyrics, and one was an instrumental. The first 10 that I have heard of, as far as the artists go, are by Porter Wagoner and Dolly Parton, a duet on February 4th, 1969, on their RCA Victor single, and also on their July 1969 RCA Victor album, Always, Always, by Carl Smith in March 1969 on his Columbia album, Faded Love and Winter Roses, by Mel Tillis in March 1969 on his Cap Records album, Who's Julie, by George Morgan in May 1969 on his Stop Records album, Like a Bird, by Norma Jean in May 1969 on her RCA Victor album, Country Giants, by Bill Anderson on June 30th, 1969 on his Decca album, My Life, But You Know I Love You, by Joe Simon in June 1969 on his Soundstage 7 album, The Chokin' Kind, then in June 1970 on his Soundstage 7 single, and by Wanda Jackson in July 1969 on her Capitol Records album, The Happy Side of Wanda, by Connie Smith and Nat Stuckey, another duet, in July 1969 on their RCA Victor album, Young Love, and by Billie Joe Spears in August 1970 on her Capitol Records album, Country Girl. There are four other cover versions by artists that I've heard of, but I've reached my self-imposed limit of 10, so I'll stop here. A little bit here about Waylon Jennings himself. Jennings was born Waylon Arnold Jennings on June 15th, 1937. That's W-A-Y-L-A-N-D, his original name. Was born on the J.W. Bittner Farm near Littlefield, Texas. The name on his birth certificate was changed after a Baptist preacher visited his parents and congratulated his mother for naming him after the Wayland Baptist University in Plainview, Texas. His mother was Church of Christ and had been unaware of the college. She changed the spelling to W-A-Y-L-O-N. Jennings was also known as Haas, Chief, Watasha, and Waymore. Some nicknames. There's another thing that I noticed that I came across, that Waylon had a production company called WGJ Productions, Inc., Incorporated. And I always thought those were his three initials. His middle name started with G. But it turns out the WGJ stood for Waylon Goddamn Jennings. There's a story of one of the first times Waylon played New York City at a club called The Bottom Line. He he was playing for a crowd of punk rock fans, long-haired hippie types, I guess, and he came on there and said, "My name is Waylon Goddamn Jennings, and we play country music, and if you don't like it, you can kiss my ass," or something like that. And then he went and played his concert, and he won the crowd over, apparently. So that's a pretty good story of his first performance in New York City for a hostile crowd, apparently, at the beginning of the concert, at least. So, well, Waylon, he performed in the country, outlaw country, and progressive country genres. He was also a songwriter, a musician, producer, and an actor. He was famous for playing a black and white leather-covered Fender Telecaster guitar. He was active in the music business from 1949 to 2000. He was forced to end his touring and public performances after pain from diabetes reduced his mobility. He was married four times and had six children, to Maxine Lawrence from 1955 to 1962 when they were divorced, with whom he had four children, two sons and two daughters, Terry Vance, who lived from 1957 to 2019, Julie Ray from 1958 to 2014, Buddy Dean, who was born in 1960, and Dina Carroll, lived from 1964 to 2015, so she was born after they had already divorced each other. His second wife was Lynn Jones, from 1962 to 1967. When they were divorced, they adopted a daughter, Tommy Lynn. His third wife was Barbara Elizabeth Rude, from 1967 to 1968. When they were divorced, they had no children. He married his fourth wife, Jessie Coulter, country singer, in Phoenix, Arizona, on October 26, 1969. They were married until Waylon's death. Coulter had a daughter, Jennifer, from her previous marriage to guitarist Duane Eddy. Waylon and Jesse had a son in 1979, Waylon Albright, known as Shooter Jennings, a musician and record producer. His middle name was named after Waylon's drummer, Richie Albright. Waylon's younger brother, Tommy, who lived from 1938 to 2019, was a country musician and played bass in Waylon's touring band, The Wailers, in the mid to late 1960s, so he would have played on Yours, Love, probably, in concerts. let's see, 333 solo records and 111 records with other artists for a total of 444 were released on Jennings between 1959 and 2014. His discography includes 45 studio albums, 5 live albums, 28 compilation albums, 16 collaborations, 16 music videos, 98 singles, and 11 charted B-sides. 16 of his singles went to number 1 in the US and 32 reached the top, if you include the rest of the world. Jennings recorded for A&M Records, MCA, and Epic in addition to RCA Victor. He was formerly a member of the Crickets, Buddy Holly's band, The Highwaymen with Johnny Cash and Kris Kristofferson. USA for Africa, that supergroup that recorded We Are the World. The Maverick Choir from the movie Maverick, which came out in 1994, and the soundtrack of that movie. And the Old Dogs with Bobby Bear and Jerry Reed and Mel Tillis, another supergroup. Jennings died on February the 13th, 2002, age 64, from complications of diabetes, in his sleep at his home in Chandler, Arizona. He's buried in the City of Mesa Cemetery in nearby Mesa. At his memorial service, Jesse Coulter sang Storms Never Last, one of their famous duets that they did together. Now, after all that, I'm going to sing Yours, Love. It's a real pretty song, so I hope you all like it. Give this thing a shot. Here we go. Like I said, there is no karaoke version of this song, so I'm going to have to sing over top of Waylon again. Here we go. Yours, Love.
May the fruit of my toil be yours, love. May the food from my soil be yours, love. And from this moment on, may a love that is strong and lives on and on be yours, love. May the sons that I raise be yours, love. May the comforts I praise be yours, love. If I ever get weak, may the lovers I speak and the arms that I seek be yours, love. May the Lord's shining grace be yours, love. May the happiest face be yours, love. May the last fingertips that touch these two lips, as life from me slips, be yours, love.
Yours, love, Waylon Jennings from 1968. Hope y'all enjoyed that song. That was a fun song for me to do. Done a whole lot of Waylon songs, but that's another beauty, I'd say. Well, I'm going to be taking a little break from these videos for a few days again. I'll be back on Monday with another song. This is actually going to be a duet song that I'm going to do. Two voices in one song, how about that? A song called A Few Old Country Boys by George Jones and Randy Travis. So, hope you all enjoy the rest of your day, and come back when I post that next video, and we'll see you then. Have a good day. Bye.